So at this point, we've filled up our dry bag, and we're gonna roll it closed so it's watertight, clip it, and now we can carry it back. As I said, we're in the public park. My husband's gonna show you our shower system. First, we open up our collapsible bucket, get it ready to heat the water. That's our heating element. We put it inside the bucket, and we prefer to run our cord underneath the door. I'll show you inside in a little bit, so we can keep the closed door and have as many insects out of the car as possible. Okay, now that we have our heating element in and we have our cord where we want it, we're gonna pour our water into our bucket. Now, like I said, you can use your bucket to get water. We just prefer this method because it allows us to get water from a lot of different sources. It's very important that you make sure that your element is completely covered with water prior to plugging it into your inverter or your power station, whatever your energy source is. Again, it has to be completely submerged in water. So here it is. Okay, so we're at like the 5 minute mark now on our water, and we're gonna heat it up because we like pretty warm showers. I mean, that's the whole point, right? But I wanted to show you, this is our collapsible bucket. It's square. It's extremely sturdy. It's made out of silicone and plastic. It collapses down to, I believe, about 2 inches, and it's about 2.5 gallons, I believe. But I wanted to let you know, this heating element, it actually would heat the water in this dry bag. If you were wanting to use a collapsible fabric bag, it'll do that too. It's not gonna damage your bucket at all. It's gonna make really, really super warm water. I did wanna show you, this is our camp shower. So one reason we don't use a dry bag and we got a collapsible bucket is because on uneven surfaces, it's more stable. Because this filter right here, this is where the water comes in, and you need that to stay pretty submersed, at least towards the bottom. Once you lose the submersion, you lose pressure, I'll be honest. But for us, it's a game changer because we don't have to stop our hikes. We don't have to stop what we're doing. We can shower whenever we want, as many times as we want. I have mid-length hair, like it's down to about the middle of my back. I don't enjoy hiking in warm weather and then having to go every other day without a shower. So this was a really good solution. Another thing I wanted to show you was this particular model comes with 2 rechargeable batteries, and the power is not inside of the filter. So you're not putting a system down into your water bucket where you can get corrosion on your battery. We also really like that. Okay, so here we are. We're at 9 minutes and 30 seconds on the timer. We're gonna walk back over here to our water. You can see the bubbles. I think you can. I don't know if you can, but you can see the bubbles. They're kind of, you know, they're in there, and this water is ready to go. So we've dropped this in. I wanted to show you. So again, there's the filter system and the pump part, and the battery is separate. We're not taking a shower tonight, but we want to show you how this works and explain to you what we do. So Steve's going to go ahead and turn this on and show it to you. So there it is. You know, that's the kind of pressure you have. You can see the water going in. So it's kind of warm. You can see him, it's a little warm. And you'll adjust that. If you use the heater, you can adjust it to yourself. But something I wanted to point out here is, obviously this isn't going to be like a 10, 20 minute shower for you. This is to get clean, right? But whenever you want. So something that we do, go ahead and do it outside the bucket. I want you guys to kind of see what's going on here. What we do, you can see how the pump is pulling the water, right? So we rinse off real good. I rinse my hair, I rinse everything really good. I get really good and saturated. At this point, I'm not sure that I'd be completely done, honest. So I'm getting really, really good and saturated inside the privacy tent at this point. So then I think at this point, I'd probably be pretty good to go. So at this point, instead of turning off the battery, we tend to set it down and we tend to put the head, back into the bucket where it's just recirculating itself, which is another reason why we make sure our water's warm. So you can see how much it's already pulled, right? This is only 2.5 gallons of water. But in a Prius, you need to conserve space, and there's two of us. So we actually need roughly 5 gallons for both of us to take a shower. At this point, I use a spray bottle. Again, I'll kind of show you. I use a spray bottle with biodegradable soap and a washcloth. And I think I'm going to go ahead and get a biodegradable bar of shampoo soap. They sell that just because I can get a better lather at my roots. But I do use some of the concentrated soap sometimes to lather at my roots when we're gone. So you're lathering up, you're spraying on your soap, you're lathering up, you're getting clean without any water running is kind of like the concept. I didn't think this was going to be enough time, but this is a lot of time to get your hair rinsed out, get yourself rinsed off. And honestly, I usually have time at this point to then spray down our washcloths and give them a good rinse and a good scrub out and hang them up. If that's how you do your thing. But here, this is the pressure. I mean, Steve, put your hand under that, can you? Just drop the battery, it's fine. Or put it in your pocket, that's good. Better idea. Go ahead and go over your arm a little bit. Like, I mean, it's pretty nice. It's pretty nice to have a constant shower at your disposal. We still have this much water. I'm gonna have him continue to hold it up so you can see, you know, you still have good, this is still good pressure. Now we're starting to lose a little and that's where we're at. I mean, like we still have pressure. I still have pressure, but it's fading a little bit. But as you can see, that's where you're at in the bucket. I mean, can you guys see that? That's how much water you have. So yeah, this is our setup. This is how we have a nice hot shower whenever we want it, pretty much wherever we want it. All right, so final step. Now that you're all clean and life is good again, you're gonna put up your Rapunda or whichever privacy shelter you choose, honestly. We just really like this one here on the ends. If Steve will pull that one out real quick. These, we just use carabiners and a sandbag, seriously. We just clip them on real quick and then clip them off. And that holds it down really, really well. But this does come with tie-out lines, which is a great feature because we do hope very soon to get to Upper Michigan and do some dispersed camping up there. So he's going to show you how quickly this will collapse. This part is a one-person job. Okay, so now Steve's gonna collapse it to go into the bag. So this is something everyone needs to practice. Okay, so I don't know if you guys could see that. Hold on, Steve. You can stand up. Yeah. So when you're doing this, it's important to understand, like the directions say are kind of confusing. And I know in reviews, people complain that it's hard to put together. And honestly, initially it is. But you can see he just put the strap over it. When you're putting this down, can you pop it back up again? Okay. When you're putting this down or packing it up to put in the bag, it's important that you always do it in one way. So we do it with Rapunda facing towards us, okay? You're gonna bend it so that you have a lot of that top room available to you, because what you're gonna do is an aggressive bend at the top to create two loops. So can you see the two loops? Yeah, see those two loops? And then it's kind of a feel thing from there. You can feel how the loops wanna go and you keep cording them until that yellow stripe is sort of on top of each other. And then that's where that string comes in. So that's the best way to do it without frustration. It's the best way to do it without frustration. It really, really is a great privacy shelter, you guys. It's really great. It's really tall. It's really wide. Has a lot of nice features. It's not super expensive. And it's super great to have the floor that comes with it. And it's a wonderful thing to have this bag because it gets, you know, they get dirty. They get wet. So anyway, there you go. And that's how we shower. That's our system. It's highly portable. Like I said, the privacy shelter, it slides under the bed. The rest of it, you can see how small the dry bag packs up. I think I have my soap in there. Oh, no, I think I have my shower in there. Sometimes I put my soap in there. It goes back down into the garage, and there's still plenty of room in the garage for multiple other items that we decide to take. He's putting it in the bag now. And so there you go. Shower anywhere you want.